Hello, with Annette here. The Teenage Murderer. The year was 1931, in the little village of Waddingham. There lived a 16-year-old boy, Harold Smith. Harold's aunt and uncle Anne and Robert Jacqueline lived at Holmes Farm, which was set apart from the village community. The day after the crime, James Jacqueline forced himself into the property, having heard no response from his son or daughter-in-law. Once inside, James heard the cries coming from upstairs. James noticed the smoldering fire in the living room before he made it upstairs. James noticed that his grandchild was crying in one of the bedrooms. With no sign of Anne and Robert, James checked in their bedroom. In that room were two bodies that were bloody, but the couple were still living. Robert was rushed to Lincoln County Hospital, as his nose and upper jaw had been shot away. While he laid on the bed in pain, Robert was still able to explain that he was not sure what happened that evening. Robert only could describe being woken up and finding Anne covered in blood. 2 days after the incident, Robert passed away. Anne was never able to make it to the hospital before she died. When the law had caught up with Harold Smith and started questioning him, Harold told two stories. In the first story, Harold had said that he did not get on well with his aunt or uncle, who had employed him as a farmhand. Harold had stated he awoke at 4:15, he picked up a shotgun and stood at their bedroom door. 4 or 5 minutes had passed while Harold decided to kill them or not. In Harold's second statement, Robert had shot Harold's aunt Anne before turning the gun on himself and committing suicide. A medical examiner said the theory was plausible, as the shotgun wounds on his face were done at close range. This theory was hard to believe for some. One moment Robert finds his wife dead, then finds a shotgun and shoots his own head. It was something the police knew the jury would be hard to convince if this story was true. As there was no more clear evidence, everyone pointed their finger at young Harold Smith. The papers even reported the terrible news. Journalists at the time of Harold's trial looked into the history of young executions. The journalists found notes of 5 people 18 of age had been executed since 1885. With these findings, many discussions were held to whether law should be reformed so Harold could spend time in jail. When in court, Harold was calm in the dock. The nagging doubt within the courtroom was the nature of gunshot wounds. Both Anne and Robert were both shot at close range. Many of those that attended the hearing highly believed Harold was guilty of the killings. James also believed Harold killed Robert, as there was blood on the walls and near the window. Robert's father believed that is where Robert stood while crying for help. When James had arrived at his son's home, Harold was nowhere to be found, which heightened people's suspicions. No one of a young age had been executed in Britain for 40 years. When the death sentence was passed to him, young Harold Smith was executed in Lincoln Prison. This sentence had been in since 1885, and by 1935, all transit to Australia had been stopped, due to how costly it really was. Probably if Harold did not tell two different stories, the court's justice could have saved him. Thank you for listening. Please like and subscribe if you enjoy my content. To keep up to date with future videos, press that notification bell. Alternatively, follow me on Twitter @withannette1.